today we are going to start with the discussion of the pestilences of Anne Frank from the diary of Anne Frank. And we have done till question number 2, where we were discussing about whether it was a diary, a journal, or it was memoir, right? So yesterday we have discussed this. Now question number 3 is, why does Anne need to give a brief character sketch about her family? And does she treat Kitty as an insider or an outsider? Yes. Who will explain? What is your opinion? Yes, Raghav? Can you speak? Raghav, your voice is not audible. I think some problem is there. So now let me explain for this question that why Anne Frank has given a brief character sketch about her family. Anne Frank has given a brief character sketch or brief description about her family. It is just because of the reason. Because if anyone would ever get a chance to read her diary, he should know about who's Annie and why she's writing her diary. She wanted to make the readers acquaint with her family members a little bit. This is the reason why she's not getting, you can say, too much personal, and she's giving a long account of the family members, but she has given a very small account or very small description of the family members. She has explained about her father, Otto Frank, who has got married at the age of 36 years when her mother, Edith Hollander Frank, was just 25 years of age. Then she has mentioned about her sister, that they both were living at Ashton along with their grandmother, and later on they were shifting. She has also made a special mention of her grandmother, that she was deeply in love and affection with her. So this is the reason she wanted to introduce the readers, if anyone would ever get a chance to read her diary, so that they should know about who's Anne and why she's writing a diary. And moreover, how she's treating her diary, Kitty, as an insider or outsider. Of course, she's treating it as an insider, not as an outsider, because she's portraying, she's noting down all the deep feelings of her mind, of her heart and mind, of her head and heart in the diary. She was not able to confide in many of the friends, and as she was not able to confide in her friends, and it is just because of this reason that she was portraying those feelings in the form of diary. So of course, this was actually an insider. Okay, insider. It means it is giving an inside picture of Anne Frank as a person. Next question is, how does Anne feel about her father, her grandmother, Mrs. Cuperus, and Mr. Keesing? What do these tell you about her? Actually, this question, it refers to Anne Frank's relation in personal with all these people. So first of all, how she's feeling for her father. For her father, she was deeply in love. Why she was deeply in love? Because she has specially mentioned, she has given a point in this chapter that her father was most adorable and no father was like her father. It means that she greatly loves her father, and moreover, as her father loved her children, he has also gifted her a diary on her 13th birthday. Although they were living in a hiding annex, they were living in, but still her father, he has managed to arrange a diary for her during that time, and he has gifted it to her. So this is the reason why she was greatly in love with her father. Next, with her grandmother, we have discussed it in a number of times, that what kind of relation Anne was sharing with her grandmother. So what kind of relation Anne was sharing with her grandmother? Anne was sharing great relationship with her grandmother, which was full of love and affection. In 1941, when her grandmother fell ill, and in 1942, she was operated. She did not survive. During the following year, she did not celebrate her birthday. Moreover, the coming year in 1943, she lit a candle in front of the portrait of her grandmother and remembering her forever in her life. She always misses her, and it is just because of the special affectionate relationship that she shares with her grandmother, that she has made a special mention of her grandmother in her diary. And afterwards, her relationship with her, or her strong relationship with her grandmother, it can also be seen. How it can be seen? It can also be seen when she was left along with her sister Margot before going to Holland. And they both were living in Ashen, and they were not going to Holland. And after 6 months of the visit of her father and mother, they have gone there. It means that they were strongly in relationship, loving relationship with their grandmother. This is the reason why the two girls were living with their grandmother afterwards. Next question is, yes, Mrs. Kuprans, her Montessori school, as she has studied in Montessori school till she was in grade 6 or class, or she was in form 6, and till there what was there, that she was she developed a great relationship with Mrs. Kuprans, the headmistress. And when she was leaving in class 6, they have tears in their eyes while being parted apart. So this shows how deeply Anne Frank was attached to her teacher, and how affectionate, understanding, and dedicated the teacher was towards her children. Next, with Mr. Keesing, what kind of relationship she was sharing with Mr. Keesing? So Mr. Keesing, you know, he was mathematics teacher of Anne Frank. At the starting, she was not sharing a good relationship, and even Mr. Keesing was thinking her as a chatterbox. This is the reason when she was talking in the class, she was given to write an essay on chatterbox. But ultimately, when she has made her arguments adaptable to the mind of Mr. Keesing, she was able to justify her point of talking and the reason of her talking. And ultimately, Mr. Keesing, he also took her essays to be read in a light-hearted manner. And moreover, he has also added on some personal comments and has read these essays in other classes too. So this is how the relationship between Anne Frank as well as Mr. Keesing changed with time. This we have studied in the chapter. Now, why does Anne say the teachers are most unpredictable? Is Mr. Keesing unpredictable, and how? Yes, of course, she was right in saying that teachers are most unpredictable creatures. Why they are unpredictable creatures? Because when they were discussing about the results, that who will pass the form and who will stay behind or stay back, they were discussing that they don't know what kind of result the teachers will present. And ultimately, this is the reason why they said the teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. And this stands true for Mr. Keesing. How it stands true for Mr. Keesing? It stands true for Mr. Keesing as Mr. Keesing, who proved to be a very strict teacher in the starting, who did not tolerate at all of talking of Anne Frank in the class, and has given her an essay to write on chatterbox. But later on, what has happened? When she has presented her arguments, he was easily justified by those arguments. He understood what she was saying. She has also told that she has inherited those qualities from her mother. Being a strict teacher, second time when he tolerated her for 2 periods, but for the 3rd period when she talked, he again gave her an essay to be written on incorrigible chatterbox. And when the 3rd essay was given, and she has presented it in the form of a poem in which the duck has bitten the 3 ducklings because they were talking more, and Mr. Keesing, he took that essay in a very light-hearted manner and was pleased to understand the arguments. And afterwards, he never punished Anne Frank. So what it means? It means that he was unpredictable, because ultimately his strict nature, it was changed into an understandable one at the end. So this is the reason we were predicting her to be strict, to punish her again and again, but ultimately the relationship changed. So this is the reason why he was unpredictable at the end. Now there are some statements given in question number 7 in which you have to tell about the character of Anne Frank. So the first one is, we don't seem to be able to get any closer, and that's the problem. Maybe it's my fault and that we didn't confide in each other. So what does this tell you about? So first of all, in which context she has talked about? She has talked about her friends, that she has a number of friends, but she was not able to confide in any of her friends. And this is the only reason why she is writing the diary. She's going to portray, she's going to present all her feelings now in the form of a diary, which she named afterwards as Kitty. So she was treating Kitty not as a, you can say, as a materialistic thing. She was considering Kitty as a person. So this shows that she was introvert in nature. She was not able to disclose her feelings to each and everyone. She was not an open book to be read by everyone, but she wanted a special space in the heart of the other persons in order to share her feelings in. This also shows little bit of her insecurity, that she was insecure at some of the points. Why she was insecure? It is just because of the reason that she wanted that her feelings should not be disclosed to everyone. Okay. So next question is, I don't want to jot down the facts in this diary the way most people would, but I want the diary to be my friend. Actually, what this tells about Anne Frank, that she needed someone with whom she should talk with whom she should share her feelings. She was not having any friend with whom she could share. But ultimately she wanted someone to talk with, to express her feelings, to express her gratitude. So this shows that she was in direst need of a friend, and a true friendship requires. Third one is, Margot went to Holland in December and I followed in February when I was plunked down onto the table as a birthday present for Margot. Means some, what kind of relationship? That she wanted to show her relationship with her sister. What kind of relationship she was sharing? Moreover, this also gives an example of the surprising nature of her parents. Okay, that they haven't told Margot that they are going to expect a baby girl, and ultimately they would be the part of the family. And this is the reason why she wanted to share this. Next one, if you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of a class should be kept back, but the teachers are most unpredictable creatures on earth. This I have already discussed with you, right? Next, anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with the convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. So what does this mean? That she wanted to be honest in her work, because when she was given a task to write an essay for the first time on Chatterbox, she thought that if anyone wanted to write, he could leave big spaces in between the words so that the essay can be formulated, but with less points. But actually what she wanted that she should be responsible as well as honest in her work. She actually wanted to prove her arguments to justify herself that she was not at all wrong in talking in the class. And she has also mentioned that it was just because of the inherited trait from her mother that she's talking a lot. And in this way, she stands against justice. She's an example that she's courageous, and moreover, she accepts also. She has a feeling of acceptance. How she is having a feeling of acceptance? That she accepts that she talks a lot in the class. So this shows her actual character. So in literature, just remember that each and every line is very, very important. It is just because of these lines, these formulation of character takes place of the main roles of the are the main lead roles of the characters in the chapter. Next, coming up to extra questions. So I'm writing the questions on the board. You can note it down on your books. First is, describe Anne's feelings about her diary. So what she feels about her diary? Who will give the answer to me? Raise up your hands so that I can unmute you. No one in the class is able to answer? Yes. Bhavna, you can speak. Yes. Bhavna, Ashima. Many good students are there in the class. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Give the answer.
Ma'am, Anne's feelings about the diary is like the diary is her best friend. And she does not have any other comrade to share her feelings with. The diary is her sole partner in all her phases of life. Everything happens, she writes in the diary.
Okay, so let me explain that Anne was not feeling her diary as a materialistic thing. She was always thinking her diary as a true friend. As she has number of friends, but she was not able to confide in any one of her friends so deeply. This is the reason why she has written her feelings in the form of diary. Moreover, she was so, understanding as well as you can say, she was greatly in belief with her diary that she has named it as Kitty. So she was treating it as her best friend. Next question. Paper has more patience than people. Why she is saying? This I'm discussing again and again. Paper has more patience than people. Explain. So what it means, paper has more patience. This is the reason why, because paper has greater patience than people, because you can write as long as you want onto the paper, because people are always reactionary in nature. They always give the reactions. When you speak something, when you say something, they are judgmental in their approach. They pass on judgments about your character, about your thinking. They approve you and disapprove you. They approve you in a positive way and disapprove you in a negative way when you give your comments and when you give your ideas or your thoughts. Moreover, people are always, you can say, critical in nature. They always criticize you for whatever you say. It is the human nature that they are always critical in nature. But in case of diary and when you write on a page, it never passes on judgments, it never criticizes you, and it is never reactionary in nature. So these are the reasons for why she thought that paper has more patience than people. And it is just because of this reason that she has written in her diary, and she has named it as Kitty. And moreover, when she did not find anybody to give a vent to her feelings. No, she did not find anybody how to overcome her depressed feelings, and she ultimately found only a single reason, that is to portray her feelings in the form of diary. At that moment, she felt relaxed. She breathed out a sigh of relief, and at that moment, she realized that yes, paper has more patience than people, right? So the next question is, what does Anne Frank tell about his family? This we have done already. Next, what does Anne write in her first essay? Yes. What does Anne write in her first essay? What she has written in her first essay? Yes. What she has written in her first essay? Akhilesh, can you answer? Unmute yourself. Will you be able to answer? No response. I think he's not able to give an answer. So let me explain that. What does Anne write? Anne, in her first essay, or because of talking in the class, Anne was given an assignment, or she was given a homework, an extra homework, to write an essay on Chatterbox. Actually, Mr. Keesing, the mathematics teacher, he was tired of her talking a lot in the class. So this is the reason why he has given her an essay to be written on Chatterbox. Later on, when she, after completing her homework, she found herself free to do that work, what she has done, she started writing an essay. And although she thought that people would ramble and people would leave big spaces in between the words in order to complete the work, but she thought that on her part, she should be true to her words. She should mention, she should explain, she would present different kind of justifications and arguments to prove that it is an unavoidable trait of her child, and any child could not stop off talking. And moreover, at the end of the essay, she has also justified her talking a lot in the class, as she has mentioned that she has inherited this trait from her mother. So she tried in every possible way to justify her talking in the class. Next is, describe about Anne's early education. Describe Anne's early education. Yes. What about her early education? So as you know, as we have read in the chapter, that she has completed her early education in Montessori Nursery School, where she has studied till class form. She has mentioned only that in her diary, and she has developed a great relationship, or affectionate, loving, understanding relationship with Mrs. Cuperus, the headmistress of the school. And when they both were departing from each other during that time, what happened, that there were tears in their eyes. Next question is, if I ask you to give a character sketch of Anne Frank, so what points we will include? Character sketch of Anne Frank. Yes, what is the character sketch of Anne Frank? What kind of girl? She was emotional in nature. Why she is emotional in nature? Because, yes, Raghav Sadana has raised up the hand. Yes, let me unmute you. Yes, Raghav, you can speak now.
Any friend is a teenager who has about 30 friends whom she can call as friends, but not a single person whom she considers as a true friend. So she has at the age of 30. She is not at all interested in writing a diary, because she sees that no one would be interested in her diary later. But she still thinks how to write, because she wants to remove the depression from her thoughts.
Okay, Raghav,
lots of problems.
Louder. Okay, so let me explain that Anne as a young girl, Anne is a young girl of 13 or 14, 13 years of age when she was gifted a diary. And in July 1942, she has started writing a diary. The reason for writing a diary was that she did not find anyone to confide in her friends, and she did not have any friends, although she had number of friends, but still she needed someone to confide in. So this is the reason why she wanted to write a diary. So what this shows? This shows her introvert nature, that she never wanted to be an open book in front of anyone. This also reflects her emotional nature, as she has developed a good relationship with number of persons. Moreover, she was affectionate. She was greatly in love with her family. She had a loving father and a loving mother along with the sister. And this is the reason why she wanted she is an emotional girl. Next is, she stands against injustice, because when she was given a punishment to write an essay about Chatterbox, she stood against that. She tried to play a joke on Mr. Keesing, and ultimately she has presented it very well in the form of poem when she has written the third essay, and Mr. Keesing had also read it in a light-hearted manner and passed on personal comments and read in the other classes too. So she has the feeling of acceptance too. Okay, how she has the feeling of acceptance, that he accepted that she is wrong as she is talking a lot in the class. But moreover, she tried to prove her point also. So this means that she was courageous, and she is, you can say, understandable in nature also. How she is understandable in nature, as she has very well understood that people would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl. So this is the reason why she has given a brief brief description of her family at the starting. She has good reasoning power also. Reasoning power, it is just because of this reasoning that she has given a brief description of her family in the starting. Moreover, she's greatly in love with her grandmother and her family. And ultimately, she wanted to be true to her words, and this is why she is writing a diary. That's all for today. And as I told you yesterday, that we will start with the one question of data interpretation. As the time was short today, we will continue with it tomorrow. Right? So tomorrow we will do a question of data interpretation, and that's all for today.